One of the most difficult tasks in an artist's career is to find a way to grow with their music. The ability to break through and mature with their sound is what separates the best from the one-hit wonders. However, in this day and age, with an ever-growing and diverse group of artists all over every depth of the internet, it's always difficult to find something new. In a sense, it's hard to find an artist that doesn't, in some way, begin to grow stale. The ability to show progression and talent by evolving style or experimenting within their range of skill is seen few and far between the sea of artists in today's music industry. That's why, when you find that special artist who's constantly reinventing the wheel, you begin to see an amazing artist take flight. If you've never heard of Smino Project before, you're in for a treat. His journey as an artist began in 2012 when he was referred to by his stage name, C-Smi. He put out his first mixtape with longtime friend Bari, titled Retail. Popularity at this stage in a musician's life is tough. Gaining a small amount of local followers, Smino changed his name and created his first independent project, Smeezy.com. After this, Smino began to create a small group of artists who shared the style of music he was producing and created what will soon become his first label, Zero Fatigue. Comprised of his producer, Monte Booker, and artist J2, Bari and Raven Lene, in 2015, his first EP, Sick Sick Sick, was released. The three-track EP had a distinct sound, and was an impressive mix of Smino's energetic vocals on smooth and groovy R&B tracks. Later in that year, the explosive Blkjuptr was released and featured 5 matured and experimental tracks. Blkjuptr found comfort in being a perfect blend of weird and catchy. Its tracks consisted of bouncy R&B songs with an energetic and wacky Smino using the groove of the beat to flow with his lyrics. Although it has many major flaws in its short 15-minute runtime, the album was a perfect follow-up project to gain more of a following. This was also the first Smino project I listened to. I immediately fell in love with the bouncy percussion, the odd vocal pitching, but mostly this zany drilling flow that could even compete with Kendrick and Drake. Soon enough, Smino dropped his first studio album, Black Swan. One of the most progressive, experimental, and potent projects of 2017. On its hour and 3-minute runtime, Smino achieved a level of maturity that I couldn't believe was possible. This project takes all the positives from Blkjuptr above and beyond. The production is amazing. The instruments in Smino's voice are so potent that even the most laid-back tracks have a level of excitement to them. The ultimate feature of the project is that it showed a new Smino. It would be a challenge to find any 2 tracks on this project that sound the same. Somehow, in some way, these tracks feel even more distant from each other, but still find a way to relate. As if the only parallel to each track is that they are both equally as absurd. These tracks pop, they combust. The energy on these tracks are second to none. The amount of quirk, thanks to Smino's egotistical character, adds an entire level of bounce to these songs when Smino quickly switches from a melodic chant to his classic machine gun flow. Bouncing vocals with his distinct pop on tracks like Innamission, coupled with his insanely catchy hooks, like on Netflix and Dusse, showcase one of the widest ranges of talents I've ever seen in the hip-hop/R&B genre. His lyrics are entertaining, painting absurdly strange pictures that somehow fit excellently with the song. To call this album entertaining is an understatement. Tracks that sound completely out of place on the first listen become more homely as you continue to listen. Even tracks I disliked on my first few listens through are amazing tracks that I enjoy almost as much or more than the tracks I initially loved.
Black Swan, I just made that shit, then I was like, oh. I'm gonna call it Black Swan. You know what I'm saying? Black Jupiter is more premeditated than Black Swan, but Black Swan just kind of just was a bunch of, it was a, you can kind of tell it's a compilation of songs.
This album was exciting. This album proved that Smino isn't just the flavor of the month. His music changed, his style evolved, and he began to find his niche. Ooh, I gotta hit me in the stick shift, power, hitting 106 miles an hour, speeding the money, your money speeding the problems, I need a break in me silence. Flash forward 1 year later, and Smino has returned with his second studio album, Noir.
Noir, what a beautiful name. Black, statuesque, you know, strong, sweet.
Noir is what I'd consider a beautiful progression of character. It still draws inspiration from his previous record, Black Swan, but in a new, refined way. Where Black Swan was a chaotic assortment of odd, funky, and bouncing tracks, Noir continues this theme in a contained and formal style. It houses some of Smino's best tracks to date, while also leaving room for small, experimental tracks that showcase his talent as an artist. Crushed Ice comes to mind. This track is quiet, but has a kicking bass. Smino's vocals are distorted and echoed, but still keep a bit of his carefree charm to it. Although this is one of the most out there tracks he's released so far in his discography, it still is able to hold its own in the entire project. Take the amazing track Hoopti, which starts as a ballad at first and slowly makes way for one of the cleanest tracks I've ever heard. This song is one of the best representations of what this album is to me. The soft intro is deceiving and shows no sign of picking up into what I believe is the most infectious flow I've ever heard him spit. Every track, in some way or another, has a different trait that separates it from the rest. After two listens through, I could already differentiate the songs from each other. This album, in a sense, is a perfect example of how an artist has mastered their craft. I hate to say it, but initially I was upset that this wasn't like Black Swan. Although they have similarities, I was upset I couldn't listen to 18 new songs that were as unique and creative as what Black Swan was. But in reality, what I got was better. When I said an artist needs to change their style up so they can mature, I left out an important piece of the puzzle. An artist can try to be different and go from genre to genre, but in the end, they end up losing the single trait that makes them different, their style. When great artists change their styles, they always have to hold on to their roots, the most important and distinguishable factor. That being said, the reason I was disappointed at first that this wasn't another installment of Black Swan is because I didn't want him to change as an artist. In fact, this is the best way to follow up such an explosive project. Noir obviously takes a lot of inspiration from Smino's previous work, but instead of going broader and even more eccentric, the tracks are toned down and perfected, each track having such a unique side of them that almost feels like this album is a collection of tracks that are the pinnacle of Smino's career. Songs I love from Black Swan and Blkjuptr don't cut close to the level of production in these tracks. Even the chemistry between Smino and his team, and even the album as a whole, don't even compare. Black Swan had a tiny, linear narrative that helped make the album feel like one collection. Noir has a bit of a stronger narrative that wraps this album into a perfect bundle of tracks. Noir excels in breaking the mold and instantly perfecting it, leaving minimal room for error. From Smino's imperfectly perfect flow to his absurdly on-point vocals, the album keeps the insanity of each track in place. From the start, the quiet and sensible Kovert slowly enters us into this new era of Smino. From the happy-go-lucky L.M.F, to the choppy but rhythmic Clink, to one of the craziest songs Smino has ever attempted, and aced, Tequila Mockingbird. How else do you describe the massive range between each and every individual song without just saying, it's crazy? And in some weird way, that's all there really is to say. I want to do this album justice. Smino is one of my most highly anticipated artists of this year, and to go from being disappointed in this last album to extremely impressed has made me rethink my opinion on him. Aside from showing the strengths of a more mature Smino, this album has made me immediately crave more from him. I want to see where he's going to take us in the next album. How often can you say that a few days after an artist drops their album, all you want is more? Once again, I find myself wanting more of this new Smino, but I know that the last thing Smino will do is stay in one lane. I hate to jump the gun, but Smino is one of those artists that I never want to see leave the game. Without doubt, we need this kind of release from all the craziness happening around us, because in a sense, that's what music really is.
Actually, I hate politics. Like, I don't like that shit. I don't keep up with it. I will put it in my song. It will reflect in my songs. It will reflect in my music. But I don't really go too deep on it. Like, you know what I'm saying? I'll be like, I'll start talking about it. Then the next line will just be back about pussy. Like, or like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't like to take shit too serious because none of this shit's real anyway, you know?
For a short while, 57 minutes to be exact, I can listen to something carefree and enjoy every last minute without a worry. From every catchy chorus to crude one-liner, Noir is another project that only continues to amaze me as I listen to it more. Smino, the beauty in being different.